Modern Warfare 2 was officially revealed yesterday by Infinity Ward and Call of Duty, and the initial logo reveal garnered more attention than the full-on reveal trailer did for Call of Duty Vanguard. It really just goes to show how much attention and hype can be garnered simply off of the reveal of a Modern Warfare game. In this video today, I want to talk a little bit more about leaks and rumors that have come out over the past few days in regard to Modern Warfare 2. Some of these leaks are in regard to multiplayer, some are in regard to Warzone. It's going to be a great conversation. I hope you all enjoy. Today's leaks and rumors are coming directly from the Ghost of Hope over on Twitter. And this first one had me extremely excited. Allegedly, Modern Warfare 2 will have a firing range, very similar to Advanced Warfare and what we saw last time in Call of Duty World War II. Same thing can be said about the one that's currently existing in Call of Duty Mobile as well. The firing range allows you to try out different attachments. Of course, you can try out weaponry, you can hit targets, you can do whatever you need to do in order to get acclimated with the weapon that you're using, and it's a great way to just test out new things that you unlock along the way. It's a real shame that we haven't had a firing range in so long, especially with these past three games that feature a gunsmith. Having the ability to swap out your attachments and have so many equipped at once really should have been a no-brainer for the developers to realize the gunsmith and the firing range go together like peanut butter and jelly. And really, one of the best things about the firing range coming back is there's really no shortage of improvement that can be made. It was kind of bare bones in the past, and we really just had to judge how much damage we were doing based off of shots it was taking to knock down specific targets, and of course, that was in a much simpler time. Now with the gunsmith, we have so many different attachments that affect the weapon in so many different ways. They could give us that feedback directly based off of the targets that we're hitting. Now, I'm not saying we need an entire breakdown, but how much damage you're doing, whether it's with numbers that pop up or on a screen after the fact that you can monitor to see exactly what your weapons did. You can also just get a feel for the weapon based off of the attachments you're using, with or without a foregrip, quick draw handle, aim down sight speeds, weapon sways, and all that different type of stuff. It really does come in handy. I do find myself going into private matches from time to time, just trying out different attachments on new weapons that release. So having that firing range would just take out the middleman. I would be able to swap my stuff on the fly, jump into the firing range really quick, and then get back into the action as soon as I'm done. And I know this is going to sound really weird, but I'd love to see them integrate the trials that we had back with Modern Warfare 2019. It wasn't really talked much about until the Games of Summer. You'd use the tickets in order to complete a trial, and when you completed it based off of your record, you would earn an XP reward. I think that would be a really cool way to give people XP for going into the firing range, completing specific trials, maybe asking to fire at things from specific distances, do like sniper trials and AR trials, SMG trials, pistol trials, etc., etc., and you'd be able to earn weapon XP for whatever weapon you're using. That would be pretty cool, and it'd be a nice way to give yourself a little bit of a boost leading into standard multiplayer matches. And that really does make me wonder just exactly how many weapon levels are going to be available in this game. I think 70 was a little too much for people in Vanguard. Maybe the sweet spot would be like 50 weapon levels at max, but who knows what's going to happen. I also just want to mention this as well, since they keep putting heavy emphasis on a new era of Call of Duty, I think it's important to note that whatever Modern Warfare 2 does will be paving the way for future Call of Duties after it, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. I'm just interested in knowing what all has changed. Based off of every single rumor that we've been seeing, there are going to be some pretty monumental changes happening with Modern Warfare 2. So in another tweet from a few days ago, the Ghost of Hope gives us a better idea on where Warzone 2 may be taking place. In this tweet, he says that the Warzone 2 map will heavily take inspiration from Medellin, Colombia. And I don't really know how to feel about that, considering there was always so many different pieces of communication between players about high-rise buildings, camping on top of buildings, you know, the different types of elevations really did cause a lot of problems. But not only that, if we look at the image itself, you know, elevation aside, it seems like it's going to be a much more close quarters, claustrophobic experience. You're really going to have your head on the swivel. You're going to have to watch your back. You're going to have to watch up above. It's almost like when you're playing through the favela mission through the campaign. I mean, it's kind of like the same exact idea. Enemies could come from any direction. They could come from anywhere. anywhere. They could be hiding in buildings. They could be hiding in windows. It just seems like there's going to be a lot going on, especially if you're in the heart of the city, which I would imagine there's going to be plenty of those points of interest all throughout the Warzone 2 experience. But I don't think it's going to be all claustrophobic all the time. Obviously, there's probably going to be open fields and maybe even some forests, and we'll probably even see different locations where it's big city, little villages, and things like that. So I'm definitely interested in seeing just exactly what type of locations that they have. I think we're still pretty far off from the reveal and the release of Warzone 2. I don't imagine that it's going to be released alongside Modern Warfare 2 at launch. I feel like it's going to have a similar release schedule to how we saw it originally back with 2019. It would be coming out earlier in the spring, come 2023. At least that's what I think is going to happen. They could surprise us all and just release it when MW2 launches, but I don't think they want to steal the thunder away from that premium release, if that makes any sense. I think they're going to try to break records, and they definitely will, considering the feedback they're already getting on the logo reveal alone. While we're on the topic of Warzone 2, the Ghost of Hope went on to say that he could only assume that the firing range will also appear in Warzone. This would honestly come in super clutch, and that's because Warzone balancing, weapon changes, attachment changes, those are normally completely separate from standard multiplayer. So having a separate firing range, giving you the ability to really hone your specific setup and get that feedback that you need in order to make it the best setup possible, would be absolutely fantastic. And of course, we know moving forward, the same engine that Modern Warfare 2 is using will be utilized across future Call of Duty games. So I think it's safe to assume that we're going to see a firing range as a core staple moving forward. And if we don't, there's a possibility that it'd be easier to implement in the future if it didn't arrive at launch. But it's nice to think that under the assumption Warzone 2 will in fact be getting a firing range, that means all future weaponry from future Call of Duty games will be able to get tested in that firing range, at least specific to Warzone weapon buff and nerfs, attachment buff and nerfs, etc. But that is everything I wanted to talk about here in this video today, and I leave you with a couple of different questions. Question number one, if you had the choice to make the weapon levels, what would the max weapon level be that you would choose? Would you stick to level 70 like we're currently seeing in Vanguard? Would you want to drop it down to level 50? Would you want to go higher to level 100? I'm interested in knowing what your thoughts are on that. Second question, if we are able to have the firing range, what type of feature would you love to see? Do you want the trials to return? Do you want the 1v1 system from World War II to return? I think there's a lot that could happen. Anyway, that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed. Drop a like on this video if you did. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, don't forget to ring the bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you when my videos go live. All right, folks, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.